Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you guys doing? I hope you guys are keeping well. In today's video, I'm going to do a very simple and a very quick, easy, everyday kind of a makeup look with a red lip. I wanted to do a very simple, everyday kind of a red lip look where you can literally rock the red lip on an everyday basis and still look really nice and very fresh. And just a minimal makeup look with a nice muted red lip, and it will make you look absolutely effortlessly flawless. I hope you guys enjoy watching my videos as much as I enjoy making them. If you do, please like and share my videos and do subscribe to my channel. And let's get started with today's video. Now, as always, I'm going to start with covering up these bad boys, and for that I'm taking my MAC Select Moisture Cover Concealer in the shade NW30. And I'm going to apply it on and around my eye area where I have the most darkness and pigmentation, and also a tad bit around my mouth area. To blend it out, I'm taking the usual beauty sponge and I'm just blending it out really nicely. And with just this one product, I already feel so much better about my under eyes. Next up, for the foundation, I wanted to keep my base really simple and very lightweight, and for that I'm taking my Makeup Forever Water Blend Face and Body Foundation. I'm taking a few pumps of it all over my face, and then with my PAC Beauty foundation brush, I'm just blending it out all over the face. Now, it will not give you any sort of a coverage. It will definitely give you a nice sheer coverage to, you know, give you that nice flawless and an even base to the face. It is extremely lightweight on the face. Now, you can see it has not given me any coverage as such, but it has still evened out my skin tone really nicely, and I really feel that nice cooling sensation on the face, just like after you washed your face with some water. Now, just to add a tad bit more coverage and to even out the skin a little bit more, I'm taking a more of a higher coverage concealer, and for that I'm taking my Makeup Forever Ultra HD Self-Setting Concealer, and I'm applying it in the usual areas where I like to conceal and highlight, that is on my under eyes, a tad bit on the eyelids to just even out any darkness there, and on the center of the face. You have seen me use this on my channel a lot of times before. This is one of my absolute favorite concealers. It is such a lightweight concealer, and it still gives you such beautiful and a very natural look to the face. It will not look drying on your face, or it will not crease on your under eyes, or, you know, look patchy at all. And it does a really beautiful job at just highlighting and concealing the areas you apply it to. And before moving on to setting my face, I'm going to take a liquid highlighter, and for that I'm taking my Kiko Milano water resistant face and body highlighter, and I'm just taking out a tiny bit of it on the back of my hand, and with the same beauty sponge I'm going to apply it on all the high points of my face to add that really beautiful and a very natural glowing from within kind of a glow to my entire face. Now, you can see it looks so nice and natural when the light hits your face. It does not look like you've applied any, you know, sort of a highlighter. It looks just like you're naturally glowing from within, and it looks really beautiful and very subtle as well. It's not a super intense or in your face kind of a highlighter. It looks really nice and very natural, and also lightweight. It is not super thick or, you know, goopy kind of a highlighter. It's super lightweight on the skin. I'm also going to take it along with my brow bone, inner corner of my eye, and also the cupid's bow. And next up, I'm going to set my face and set my concealer, and for that I'm taking my MAC Studio Fix powder in the shade NC25. and I was just taking it on a fluffy powder brush like this, and I'm applying it on my under eyes where I've applied the concealer, on my eyelids, and then a very small amount on the rest of my face. I'm not going to apply it on top of the highlighter that we've applied on the face. And then before moving forward, I'm going to quickly go ahead and fill in my eyebrows off the camera, and I'm back. Next up, I'm going to bronze up my face, and for that today I'm taking my Kiko Milano Unexpected Paradise bronzer. And I mentioned it in my top 10 bronzers video, which I link here on the screen above if you haven't checked it already. And I'm going to use it to just bronze up my face really nicely, to add some color and warmth back to the skin. Now it's a super pigmented kind of a very warm toned bronzer. I just went overboard with this on this side of my face. So I'm just going to tone it down using my beauty sponge. It's a really beautiful and a very warm toned bronzer. You do get some really nice shades in this. It's a really beautiful bronzer, and the fragrance on this is just divine. So I'm also going to take it all over my eyelid because I will not be using any eyeshadows in today's look. I'm also going to run it along with my lower lash line using a flatter shader brush. I'm going to add a bit more of a highlight to my brow bone and inner corner of the eyes. And for the blush, I'm taking my Tarte Amazonian Clay Blush in the shade Flare. It's a beautiful peachy pink kind of a blush, and it will give you that beautiful glowy blush to the face. It will make you look like you're glowing from within while still adding a really nice and a very fresh flush of color all over the face. And then to finish off the eye look, I'm taking my e.l.f. Length and Volume Mascara. And I am adding 2 to 3 heavy coats of this on my eyelashes. Now this is more of a daily wear kind of a mascara. It is not a super volumizing mascara. However, it does add a really nice and a very beautiful length to your eyelashes. It is not a super dramatic kind of a mascara. I would say it is more of your everyday kind of a mascara where you need some nice definition to your eyelashes. It will add a really nice length to your eyelashes while also giving them that beautiful curl, and it will also hold on to that curl really nicely throughout the day. I'm also adding a tiny bit of it along with my lower lashes because I'm not going to add any liner or kajal on my eyes today. For the last and final step, I'm going to add a really nice and a very subtle red lip, and for that I'm taking my Burberry Lip Velvet Crush in the shade Military Red. Now it is a sponge kind of an applicator and gives you more of that lip tint kind of a look. It will not give you a super defined red lip look. It will give you more of a muted and a very beautiful tint kind of a red lip, and it will still look really nice and very fresh and natural on the face. It dries down to be completely matte and a transfer proof formula, and it will give you more of that lip powder kind of a look, and it feels really lightweight on the lips. You do not feel like you've applied any lip color on the lips, and it will look really nice and lasts you really beautifully throughout the day. And well, that is it guys. This is the final finished look. Now I really love how this makeup look has turned out. It looks so nice and fresh, very lightweight and super natural with just a beautiful red on your lips, and it is perfect to be worn on an everyday basis, and you can literally wear it with anything and it will look absolutely beautiful on each and every one of you guys. I hope you guys enjoy watching my videos as much as I enjoy making them for you. If you do, please like and share my videos and do subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you. Bye bye.